I feel the burn, man. I feel the burn.
My arms are completely warm right now. Hey, Janda, how's your pillow?
I love my pillow pet.
Okay, guys. I'm feeling the burn a little too much now.
I wanted a pillow pet. How come I had to have this stupid ShamWow?
That's what happens when you drop a shake weight on someone's foot. So shine that table, old man.
I couldn't sleep. What's going on?
My grandpa's visiting and he brought us a bunch of infomercial goodies.
Well, it looks like legendary folk singer Stewie Martin brought the whole Lassie on TV catalog with him.
You can have my shake weight, but I can't find the off button.
What'd you get? Back off!
This is my pillow pet, and we're best friends.
You can have my ShamWow. It's awesome.
Your presents suck.
Back to work. I'll try out my included free gift, Slap Chop, on your man berries.
Look at all this free crap I got on the way to the vending machine. I even talked a hobo out of an artificial leg.
Yay! Grandpa Claus is back.
And who's this Christmas cutie that Santa forgot to bring a present for?
I used to date your grandson, but he decided he didn't want to date anymore.
Well, here's a consolation prize. Now, this strongly resembles a chia pet.
I've always wanted one of these. My dad never let me have it.
Oh. Chet's gonna be mad.
The chia pet stays no matter what.
Yes!
What else did you bring, Mr. Martin?
I didn't bring anything.
Wolf, Slap Chop, manberries. Got it? Now keep cleaning.
I want something.
Well, here, you can have all of it. I don't care. This crap, I got it. Who wants to chug a power drink and then defecate in the swim team practice pool?
What?
Last one in has to do a nasty lap.
Nasty lap?
Is he talking about the doo-doo water? It won't turn off. Come on, guys, seriously, it's really burning now. Don't leave me. Oh, God, it's still going.
Now, now, now.
Han, Janda, I need water.
Go away. Watching.
I can't lift my arms. You guys left me here with this stupid shake weight all night.
Why don't you man up?
Why don't you lady up? Shut up.
You're an idiot.
Hey, Skinny Chesney.
Vat, you're looking taller, man. Man, you look terrible. Did you have a kegger last night?
No, shake weight, man.
All right, yeah, I hear you.
Big Shaggy's banana.
Hey, Pops, you wait?
Well, if I am, my worst nightmare just came true.
Oh, yeah? What's that? The 80s hairband generation became old and lame? Oh, wait, that already happened.
No, that you're here. I thought I told you to never come back with your twangy country music.
Listen, Pops, Gramps is on the loose again.
I know. How do you think this place got like this?
Wait, he's here? That would explain the snuggie and the shake weight.
Oh, that's harsh, man.
Dean Koontz?
Hi, Dean Koontz. Hi, Dean Koontz.
So wait, so you mean your name is Dean Koontz? No, you're right. I'm sorry. That's not funny at all.
Turn off the lights, man!
Hello, Dean Richard Koontz.
Mr. Myers, shouldn't you be presenting a case to the student council in less than 2 hours?
Oh my God, Janda, how can you do this to me?
How is that my fault?
I told you to remind me! Hey, Janda, remind me about that thing tomorrow. I take silence as confirmation. I'm glad we agree. We have to go right now!
Mom got you.
Hey, your name is Dick Koontz?
That's Dean Koontz to you, Mr. Von Wolfen.
Now, listen. I love all your books, by the way.
Ms. Laymore reports you've been absent from her class for most of the semester. To be in college at your age, you'd think you'd make better life choices.
Hey, I've shown up for all my phys ed classes.
My point exactly. Now, where is Josh Martin? He resides in this domicile, correct?
Yeah, actually, he's right here. Hey, wake up, Nancy.
Clint,
the dean of students is here to see you.
Well, good morning. Think we might have passed out last night.
What the hell?
Why would you react like that?
Well, isn't that how you'd want me to react?
No, I just think that we should be more comfortable around each other.
I think you need to make up your mind.
Ms. Walters, you are aware that it's against school policy for a female to stay in a male dorm?
Yes, Mr. Koontz, it won't happen again.
So that must be Casey, huh? Seems like she's really into you.
Are you a student here?
Yeah, I'm leaving. Hey, I'll catch up with you later.
I'm sorry, Mr. Koontz.
Drinking on campus?
Yep. Well, I mean, no. Well, yeah, but it's not alcohol. It's an energy drink. I don't remember what happened.
Energy drink. Congrats, Mr. Martin. It's not every day I hear an excuse I haven't heard.
Oh, you're welcome.
What is it we can help you with, Dean Koontz?
Well, apparently, someone contaminated the swim team's practice pool. And the person who saw the crime said that the persons residing here committed the prank.
What? I don't remember.
Unfortunately,
anything.
That same witness claims to have seen legendary folk singer Stewie Martin committing the crime. The validity of that would never stand up in court.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I mean, what are they going to say next? They saw Bob Dylan urinating in the cafeteria?
I've seen that. No big thing. I mean, it wasn't an issue. Not that his thing wasn't big. I mean, I didn't even look.
The point being, you and your crew of degenerates are now on my radar. And let me assure you, that is not where you want to be.
No, sir.
I'll have my eye on you, Martin. If I hear the slightest of offenses coming from this dorm, I will have you kicked off campus so fast, it'll make your head spin.
Oh, already there, bud.
Hey, Dick.
That's Dean Koontz to you, sir.
What happened in this place?
We've got to find my grandpa.
Zach Meyer is presenting his proposal to reinstate the campus cooking club.
Mr. Meyer, you may state your case.
One more try.
Really, Janda, you can't just adjust it.
Good idea. I hadn't thought of that.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I'm here today to plead my case.
This is not a jury case, Mr. Meyer.
Right? Sorry, Your Highness. I'm here today to talk about food, a necessity that we all must endure. But should we be forced to simply endure, or should we enjoy? The ability to cook is what set America in motion to break free of English oppression during the Revolutionary War.
Are you really suggesting that the Revolutionary War was started over cuisine?
Have you ever eaten British cooking? I did once, and it inspired me to run the halls screaming, "The British are coming! The British are coming!" Much like our fellow American patriot Paul Revere did so many years ago.
Mr. Meyer, Paul Revere wasn't concerned with British food.
Who are you or I or any one of us in these hallowed halls to question history? Furthermore, why do you think he started a chain of pizza joints? Do we want to eat communist bangers and mash, or do we want delicious, democratically elected Paul Revere's pizza?
Wanted to see me?
Yes, Mr. Martin, come in.
I don't think I should. So you had this tendency to...
pass out unexpectedly?
Yeah.
It is a condition, Mr. Martin. When I enter into an excited state, I tend to faint.
That is awesome! Lee bad.
It is a curse, Mr. Martin.
You can call me Wolf.
Nah, I think Mr. Martin will suffice. I made the mistake of being a bit too forward in our first encounter, and we need to keep a strict professional relationship.
Oh, we both are adults.
Well, that's certainly arguable, Mr. Martin. Unfortunately, I am your teacher and you are my student.
You said you grew up listening to my music.
So did a lot of people.
You said I was a musical genius.
I don't think I said that word specifically.
You get excited when you're around me.
I think you misunderstood the context.
You're totally into me.
I never said that.
You didn't have to. I've seen Van Halen's video for Hot for Teacher like a gazillion times. I know the routine.
This conversation has become inappropriate, Mr. Martin.
And do you like inappropriate, Miss Lamar? That's hot.
Wolf, Mr. Martin, I don't dig people. I'm a tenured professor. And furthermore, wipe that smug smile off of your face. Well, I never...
Hey, Miss Lamar, come...
Say what, listen, she passed out. Into my lap!
Red touch! Red touch! No!
Did you find anything?
Nothing.
Garbage can, really?
Seriously, nothing.
You guys found him?
We checked all the girls' bathrooms and didn't find anything.
Yeah. I guess that was my brother's idea.
Yeah, he said... You're a pervert!
Well, hey, bro. Check those garbage cans.
We did.
Well, did you dig down deep to see if he was covering himself up to keep warm?
I'm not big enough for that.
All right, don't get your panties in a bunch, dweeb.
Yeah, it's like he's having his man period. Yeah.
I'm such a dweeb.
Dweeb, really?
What are we, 12?
Yep, which makes this perfectly acceptable.
Knock it off. Hey.
Hey, why are we looking for him anyway? He's a grown man.
Hey, you don't know our Grandpa Stewie. He can be a bit eccentric.
Yeah, he used to be. Now I think he's just senile.
Really?
Yeah, that's why I came to find him. He escaped from the facility I had him staying at.
You put him in a home?
Oh, that's cool!
I'm totally putting you in a home.
I don't think you guys remember or not, but he ain't exactly firing on all cylinders anymore.
Well, I guess that does explain all the infomercial stuff.
Yeah, you know, I used to take him on tour with me until he started making stage streaking a nightly occurrence.
Oh, thanks for the mental image.
It wasn't pretty, kind of like a turtle head hanging off a bag of fur of pudding, I don't know.
Pudding? Vanilla or chocolate?
Hey, everybody, let's just shut up and keep looking. I don't want to search for him all day. Just find Gramps and go home.
Well, if we're searching into the night, we could go camping. You have a sleeping bag?
Yeah, I got my sleeping bag.
Wake it up, then, Dwayne.
Listen. Do you hear that? Come here.
Come on. So, Casey's single now, huh?
I don't even think about it.
I can't help it, man. She is a pretty girl.
Man, isn't that like some kind of sacred rule, thou shalt not covet thy bro's ex-girl?
So you want her back, then?
It's not about that.
Well, she's fair game.
Not in the least.
You're just a hot mess, ain't you?
Yeah. I think I want her back.
But she said that you broke up with her.
I did. I think I made a mistake.
Really? Well, then tell her, bro.
I can't. I mean, she has a boyfriend now.
Now, she was your girlfriend first. So all's fair, little brother, man. Go get her.
Come on, what are you guys doing?
Mr. Meyer, you have thus far failed to give one credible reason why this council should reinstate the crude cooking club that we banned 9 years ago.
You keep saying bad taste. Well, let me bring some good taste back to this campus. Allow me the free right to perform my cooking practice where and when I see fit. This country was founded on the ideology of freedom of cuisine.
For the last time, Mr. Meyer, the formation of this country had nothing to do with food. We've always been able to eat freely of what we choose.
Exactly! In order to have the freedom to eat whatever we want, we must endure the foods that we don't want. Like fried toast and kipper, or cream-filled weenies.
I'd rather enjoy a good cream-filled weenie from time to time.
Yeah, I bet she does.
What was that you said?
Free the food. We didn't land on Paul Revere's pizza. It landed on us.
Excuse me?
Did you fart?
Order! Order!
I just want to cook. You can't judge me by the actions of others just because they're also cooks. Ideas aren't violent, man. People are.
I think that's a very valid point.
Yes, I agree. Wait, what?
I vote we allow the return of the cooking club.
Yeah, I agree.
You can't be serious.
You can't handle the truth. Always wanted to say that.
The council votes 2 against and 3 for. Mr. Meyer, your request is granted. Though you will slip up, and when you do...
Yeah, you'll be there. Cliche much?
Four dead in Ohio.
Good show, old man. Soak this in, students. We have a living legend in our midst.
Oh, go on. I'm just an old guy who likes to horse around with this thing.
Oh, brother.
What?
If you ever need a job, Mr. Martin, there's a standing offer here at the college. Mm-hmm. Perhaps you can keep your grandson over there in line.
Yeah, I understand this boy's been giving you a little bit of trouble, Dean Kuntz.
Grandpa.
No, Dean Kuntz has been telling me stories. Spinning stories that could add up to a novel about you.
I assure you, Dean Kuntz, I'm a perfectly good student.
Well, what the dean's been telling me is that you've been suspected of doing your business in the practice pool. Now, I'd call that a horror story. Wouldn't you call it a horror story, Dean Kuntz?
Yes, indeed.
Yes, I would too. Well, don't worry, I'm going to take care of this boy. He's a real odd Thomas, I'll admit it, but we're going to work it out back in the dorm. Come on, kids, back to the dorm. Oh. We got a lot of work to do.
He didn't even get your joke.
He's a retard.
Yeah. So your grandpa's going to take the adjunct music position?
Yeah, Clint said I have to keep an eye on him for a while.
That's crazy. 3 generations of the Martins on the same campus.
Kind of scary, huh?
Maybe.
You know, Casey, I've been thinking.
Ooh, sounds dangerous.
Well, you know, me and you get along really well, and, I mean, besides Zach, you're like my best friend.
Besides Zach?
Well, I mean, we're soulmates.
Yeah. Too bad he's a guy.
Yeah, tell me about it.
What?
Huh?
What were you saying?
Oh, I was just thinking that maybe we might have ended things a little bit too quickly.
Hey.
Hey, babe. Been looking everywhere for you. Sup, J-Dog?
Hey, Herbie.
What were you saying?
It's nothing. I'll see you guys later.
So, Caseinator. Spent 3 hours on my hair this morning. What do you think?